First of all, I will be using a Raspberry Pi 4 here. I have installed Raspbian on it and set up SSH. In this state, I will try to connect to the Raspberry Pi via SSH. I am now connected to the Raspberry Pi. I will install a few packages in the Raspberry Pi terminal. Before that, just to be safe, please update the package list with sudo apt-get update. This command will refresh the list of available packages and their versions, ensuring that you have the latest information. However, it will not install or upgrade any packages. After that, we will install the necessary packages using sudo apt-get install gitlibusb 1.0.0.dv g++ build essential. This command will download and install the specified packages, ensuring that all dependencies are met and the system is ready for further development tasks. For your reference, the example I'm showing you can be executed not only on Raspbian, but also on any Debian-based Linux distribution. And if you don't want to proceed with the example, just type -y and press enter. This completes the installation. Now I will download the necessary source code. Git clone hpsgit.com charmed labs php2. This will simply do and work. The source code related to php2 is downloaded. Now let's build the necessary library that we need. First, navigate to the Pixy2 directory that you downloaded, and then move to the scripts folder. Here, you will find a script for building the USB library. Please execute the build USB Pixy USB 2 shell script. Next, let's proceed. To build an example of an API using the blocks, this process will be similar to what we did previously with Arduino, where we utilized various components and modules to create a functional system. I have built this example by creating a shell script for LockSeep demo. Now let's run the built example. Type cd and you will see that there is a build folder inside. Move into the build folder, and in this state, you will find the getblocks.cpp demo folder. Go into the getblocks.cpp demo folder, and if you check the files again, you will see that there is now a built example. If you run sudo getblocks.cpp demo, the example will execute, and in this state, I will place an object in front of it. As you can see now, I have connected PC2 and the Raspberry Pi via USB. In this state, if I place an object that can be recognized in front of it, you will see information about the recognized object displayed in the terminal, just like when we did the Arduino example last time. Please turn off the example and come to the top path of PC2. From this state, if you search the folder again, you will find the source file folder here. Go into the SRC folder, then simply enter the host and just search. You will find the example you just built inside the libpixyusb2 examples folder. Enter the libpixyusb2 examples folder, and from there, if you search again, you will see the getblocks.cpp demo at the bottom. Go here. And if you search again, in this state, you will now see the CPP file. Let's take a look at it. The above is just a comment, so please ignore it. If you take a look, you'll see that there is a main function here. It is set up to turn off when you press Ctrl C and when the example is executed with printf. These messages are displayed and then it is somewhat similar to Arduino. When working with Arduino, we use Pixy, and if you look here, we have included the library with libpixy-osbu header, such as, for example, in this case, here, similar to the Arduino, we declare the Pixy2 variable as Pixy, and we have a static variable set up to check whether it runs or not in the following code. The handle sig interrupt function is used to confirm this, and there is a variable called run underbar flag that is used when we want to terminate the program. Next, there is the getBlocks function, which will likely be called later. If you scroll down, you will see that after initializing Pixy, if the result is negative or zero, it will be judged as an error, and an error message will likely be displayed. If not, it will indicate success. Then, just like when we executed the example earlier, where the Pixy version information was displayed, we will retrieve the version here and print it out. If we cannot retrieve the version, the program will terminate just like during the initialization. And just like we saw with our Arduino, we use change probe to set the program running on Pixy2 to the color connected components program. And here we have an infinite loop that continuously calls getBlocks, which is a crucial part of the process. But now, if you simply press Ctrl+C and the blinking variable for the run flag becomes a pulse, then the program will terminate, displaying Pixy to getBlocks demo exit. The important part will be in getBlocks. When you go to getBlocks, it should be similar to the Arduino side. You can enter the command pc:ccc getBlocks to retrieve information, and then check with pc:ccc.nunblocks whether the number of recognized objects is greater than or equal to zero or exactly zero. This allows you to decide whether to enter or exit. If the number of recognized objects is greater than zero, it will display the count of recognized objects, and from there, it will again be similar to the Arduino side. On the block side, the corresponding object is set to be output through the print command. In this session, we connected Pixy2 to the Raspberry Pi and controlled it via the API. I found that it is very similar to how we controlled it with Arduino in the previous session. In the next session, I will explain how to control Pixy2 using UART, I2C, SPI, or other interfaces. Then, I will see you next time.